Odessa or Odessa is the third most populous city of Ukraine and a major tourism center, seaport and transport hub located on the northwestern shore of the Black Sea. It is also the administrative center of the Odessa Rayon and Odessa Oblast, as well a multi-ethnic cultural center. Odessa is sometimes called the Pearl of the Black Sea, the South Capital, and Southern Palmyra. Before the Tsarist establishment of Odessa, an ancient Greek settlement existed at its location. A more recent Tatar settlement was also founded at the location by Hajji Guri, the Khan of Crimea in 1440 that was named after him as Hasibi. After a period of Lithuanian Grand Duchy control, Hasibi and surroundings became part of the domain of the Ottomans in 1529 and remained there until the empire's defeat in the Russo-Turkish War of 1792. In 1794, the city of Odessa was founded by a decree of the Russian Empress Catherine the Great. From 1819 to 1858, Odessa was a free port, a Porto Franco. During the Soviet period, it was the most important port of trade in the Soviet Union and a Soviet naval base. On 1 January 2000, the quarantine pier at Odessa Commercial Seaport was declared a free port and free economic zone for a period of 25 years. During the 19th century, Odessa was the fourth largest city of Imperial Russia, after Moscow, St. Petersburg and Warsaw. Its historical architecture has a style more Mediterranean than Russian, having been heavily influenced by French and Italian styles. Some buildings are built in a mixture of different styles, including Art Nouveau, Renaissance and Classicist. Odessa is a warm waterport. The city of Odessa hosts both the Port of Odessa and Port Yuzhna, a significant oil terminal situated in the city's suburbs. Another notable port, Chornomorsk, is located in the same oblast, to the southwest of Odessa. Together they represent a major transport hub integrating with railways. Odessa's oil and chemical processing facilities are connected to Russian and European networks by strategic pipelines. Current population is 1,017,699. Name. The city was named in compliance with the Greek plan of Catherine the Great. It was named after the ancient Greek city of Odessos, which was mistakenly believed to have been located here. Odessa is located in between the ancient Greek cities of Tyras and Albia, different from the ancient Odessos's location further west along the coast, which is at present-day Varna, Bulgaria. Catherine's Secretary of State Adrian Gribovsky claimed in his memoirs that the name was his suggestion. Some expressed doubts about this claim, while others noted the reputation of Gribovsky as an honest and modest man. History. Early history. Odessa was the site of a large Greek settlement no later than the middle of the 6th century BC. Some scholars believe it to have been a trade settlement established by the Greek city of Histria. Whether the Bay of Odessa is the ancient port of the Histrians cannot yet be considered a settled question based on the available evidence. Archaeological artifacts confirm extensive links between the Odessa area and the Eastern Mediterranean. In the Middle Ages, successive rulers of the Odessa region included various nomadic tribes, the Golden Horde, the Crimean Khanate, the Grand Duchy of Lithuania, and the Ottoman Empire. Yedisan Crimean Tatars traded there in the 14th century. Since middle of the 13th century, the city's territory belonged to the Golden Horde domain. On Italian navigational maps of 14th century, on the place of Odessa is indicated the castle of Ginestra, at the time the center of a colony of the Republic of Genoa. At times when the northern Black Sea littoral was controlled by the Grand Duchy of Lithuania, there existed a settlement of Kachibe, which at first was mentioned in 1415. By middle of 15th century, the settlement was depopulated. During the reign of Khan Hajji Guri of Crimea, the Khanate was endangered by the Golden Horde and the Ottoman Turks, and, in search of allies, the Khan agreed to cede the area to Lithuania. The site of present-day Odessa was then a fortress known as Kadibi. Ottoman Silistor. Kadibi came under direct control of the Ottoman Empire after 1529 as part of a region known as Yedisan after one of Nogay hordes, and was administered in the Ottoman Silistra Ilay, Sanjak of Ozi. In the mid-18th century, the Ottomans rebuilt the fortress at Kadibi, which was named Yeni Dunya. Hokebi was a Sanjak center of Silistra province. Russian conquest of Sanjak of Ozi, Ochakov Oblast. The sleepy fishing village that Odessa had witnessed a sea change in its fortunes when the wealthy magnate and future voivode of Kiev, Antony Protasy Potocki, established trade routes through the port for the Polish Black Sea Trading Company and set up the infrastructure in the 1780s. During the Russian-Turkish War of 1787-1792, on the 25th of September 1789, a detachment of the Russian forces, including Zaporozhian Cossacks under Alexander Suvorov and Ivan Gudovich, took Kotyba and Yeni Dunya for the Russian Empire. One section of the troops came under command of a Spaniard in Russian service, Major General José de Ribas. Today, the main street in Odessa, Deribasovska Street, is named after him. Russia formally gained possession of the Sanjak of Ozi as a result of the Treaty of Jassy in 1792, and it became a part of Yekaterinoslav Viceroyalty. The newly acquired Ochakov Oblast was promised to the Cossacks by the Russian government for resettlement. On permission of the Archbishop of Yekaterinoslav Amvrasi, the Black Sea Kosh host, that was located around the area between Bender and Ochakiv, built second after Sukleya Wooden Church of St. Nicholas. By the highest rescript of the 17th of June 1792 addressed to General Kokoski, it was ordered to establish the Dniester border line of fortresses. The commander of the land forces in Ochakiv Oblast was appointed Graf Suvorov Rimniksky. The main fortress was built near Sukleya at the mouth of Riverbotna as the head Dniester fortress by Engineer Major de Wallant. Near the new fortress saw the formation of a new Vorstadt, where people moved from Sukleya and Parkin. With the establishment of the Voznesensk Governorate on the 27th of January 1795, the Vorstadt was named Tiraspol. The city of Odessa, founded by the Russian Empress Catherine the Great, centers on the site of the Turkish fortress Kocabey, which was occupied by a Russian army in 1789. The Flemish engineer working for the Empress, Franz de Vollen, recommended the area of Kocabey Fortress as the site for the region's basic port. It had an ice-free harbor, breakwaters could be cheaply constructed that would render the harbor safe, and it would have the capacity to accommodate large fleets. The namestnik of Yekaterinoslav in Voznesensk, Platon Zubov, supported this proposal, and in 1794 Catherine approved the founding of the new port city and invested the first money in constructing the city. However, adjacent to the new official locality, a Moldavian colony already existed, which by the end of the 18th century was an independent settlement named Moldavanka. Some local historians consider that the settlement predates Odessa by about 30 years and assert that the locality was founded by Moldavians who came to build the fortress of Yeni Dunia for the Ottomans and eventually settled in the area in the late 1760s, right next to the settlement of Kotyba, on what later became the Primorsky Boulevard. Another version posits that the settlement appeared after Odessa itself was founded, as a settlement of Moldavians, Greeks and Albanians fleeing the Ottoman yoke. Renaming of the settlement and establishment of seaport. In 1795 Kotyba was officially renamed as Odessa after a Greek colony of Odessos that supposedly was located in the area. In reality it was located at the mouth of Tylihul estuary. The first census that was conducted in Odessa was in 1797, which accounted for 3,455 people. Since 1795, the city had its own city magistrate, and since 1796 a city council of 6 members and the Odessa Commodity Exchange. In 1801 in Odessa had opened the first commercial bank. In 1803 the city accounted for 9,000 people. In their settlement, also known as Novaya Slobodka, the Moldavians owned relatively small plots on which they built village-style houses and cultivated vineyards and gardens. What became Mikhailovsky Square was the center of this settlement and the site of its first Orthodox church, the Church of the Dormition, built in 1821 close to the seashore, as well as of a cemetery. Nearby stood the military barracks and the country houses of the city's wealthy residents, including that of the Duke de Richelieu, appointed by Tsar Alexander I as governor of Odessa in 1803. Richelieu played a role during Ottoman plague epidemic which hit Odessa in the autumn 1812. Dismissive of any attempt to forge a compromise between quarantine requirements and free trade, Prince Kuryakin countermanded Richelieu's orders. In the period from 1795 to 1814 the population of Odessa increased 15 times over and reached almost 20,000 people. The first city plan was designed by the engineer F. de Vollen in the late 18th century. Colonists of various ethnicities settled mainly in the area of the former colony, outside of the official boundaries, and as a consequence, in the first third of the 19th century, Moldavanka emerged as the dominant settlement. After planning by the official architects who designed buildings in Odessa's central district, such as the Italians Francesco Carlo Boffo and Giovanni Torricelli, Moldavanka was included in the general city plan. though the original grid-like plan of Moldovankin streets, lanes and squares remained unchanged. The new city quickly became a major success, although initially it received little state funding and privileges. Its early growth owed much to the work of the Duke de Richelieu, who served as the city's governor between 1803 and 1814. Having fled the French Revolution, he had served in Catherine's army against the Turks. He is credited with designing the city and organizing its amenities and infrastructure, and is considered one of the founding fathers of Odessa, together with another Frenchman, Count Andro de Langeron, who succeeded him in office. Richelieu is commemorated by a bronze statue, unveiled in 1828 to a design by Ivan Mardos. His contributions to the city are mentioned by Mark Twain in his travelogue Innocents Abroad. I mention this statue and this stairway because they have their story. Richelieu founded Odessa, watched over it with paternal care, labored with a fertile brain and a wise understanding for its best interests, spent his fortune freely to the same end, endowed it with a sound prosperity, and one which will yet make it one of the great cities of the Old World. In 1819, the city became a free port, a status it retained until 1859. It became home to an extremely diverse population of Albanians, Armenians, Azeris, Bulgarians, Crimean Tatars, Frenchmen, Germans, Greeks, Italians, Jews, Poles, Romanians, Russians, Turks, Ukrainians, and traders representing many other nationalities. Its cosmopolitan nature was documented by the great Russian poet Alexander Pushkin, who lived in internal exile in Odessa between 1823 and 1824. In his letters he wrote that Odessa was a city where the air is filled with all Europe, French is spoken and there are European papers and magazines to read. Odessa's growth was interrupted by the Crimean War of 1853 to 1856, during which it was bombarded by British and Imperial French naval forces. It soon recovered and the growth in trade made Odessa Russia's largest grain exporting port. In 1866, the city was linked by rail with Kiev and Kharkiv as well as with Iasi in Romania. The city became the home of a large Jewish community during the 19th century, and by 1897 Jews were estimated to comprise some 37% of the population. The community, however, was repeatedly subjected to anti-Semitism and anti-Jewish agitation from almost all Christian segments of the population. Pogroms were carried out in 1821, 1859, 1871, 1881 and 1905. Many Odessan Jews fled abroad after 1882, particularly to the Ottoman region that became Palestine, and the city became an important base of support for Zionism. Beginnings of revolution. In 1905, Odessa was the site of a workers' uprising supported by the crew of the Russian battleship Potemkin and the Mensheviks Iskra. Sergei Eisenstein's famous motion picture The Battleship Potemkin commemorated the uprising and included a scene where hundreds of Odessan citizens were murdered on the Great Stone Staircase, in one of the most famous scenes in motion picture history. At the top of the steps, which lead down to the port, stands a statue of the Duke de Richelieu. The actual massacre took place in streets nearby, not on the steps themselves, but the film caused many to visit Odessa to see the site of the slaughter. The Odessa Steps continue to be a tourist attraction in Odessa. The film was made at Odessa's Cinema Factory, one of the oldest cinema studios in the former Soviet Union. Following the Bolshevik Revolution in 1917 during Ukrainian-Soviet War, Odessa saw two Bolshevik armed insurgencies, the second of which succeeded in establishing their control over the city. For the following months, the city became a center of the Odessa Soviet Republic. After signing of the Brest-Litovsk Treaty, all Bolshevik forces were driven out by the 13th of March 1918 by the combined armed forces of the Austro-Hungarian Army, providing support to the Ukrainian People's Republic. With the end of the World War I and withdrawal of armies of Central Powers, the Soviet forces fought for control over the country with the Army of the Ukrainian People's Republic. A few months later, the city was occupied by the French army and the Greek army that supported the Russian White Army in its struggle with the Bolsheviks. The Ukrainian general Nikifor Grigoriev, who sided with Bolsheviks, managed to drive the unwelcome Triple Entente forces out of the city, but Odessa was soon retaken by the Russian White Army. Finally, by 1920, the Soviet Red Army managed to overpower both Ukrainian and Russian White Army and secure the city. The people of Odessa suffered badly from a famine that resulted from the Russian Civil War in 1921-1922 due to the Soviet policies of Prodravirska. World War II. Odessa was attacked by Romanian and German troops in August 1941. The defense of Odessa lasted 73 days from the 5th of August to the 16th of October 1941. The defense was organized on three lines with emplacements consisting of trenches, anti-tank ditches and pillboxes. The first line was 80 kilometers long and situated some 25 to 30 kilometers from the city. The second and main line of defense was situated 6 to 8 kilometers from the city and was about 30 kilometers long. The third and last line of defense was organized inside the city itself. A medal, for the defense of Odessa, was established on the 22nd of December 1942. Approximately 38,000 medals were awarded to servicemen of the Soviet Army, Navy, Ministry of Internal Affairs, and civil citizens who took part in the city's defense. It was one of the first four Soviet cities to be awarded the title of Hero City in 1945. Lyudmila Pavlichenko, the famous female sniper, took part in the battle for Odessa. Her first two kills were effected near Belyayevka using a Mosin Nagant bolt-action rifle with a PE-4 power scope. She recorded 187 confirmed kills during the defense of Odessa. Pavlichenko's confirmed kills during World War II totaled 309. Before being occupied by Romanian troops in 1941, a part of the city's population, industry, infrastructure and all cultural valuables possible were evacuated to inner regions of the USSR and the retreating Red Army units destroyed as much as they could of Odessa's remaining harbor facilities. The city was land-mined in the same way as Kiev. During World War II, from 1941 to 1944, Odessa was subject to Romanian administration, as the city had been made part of Transnistria. Partisan fighting continued, however, in the city's catacombs. Following the siege of Odessa and the Axis occupation, approximately 25,000 Odessans were murdered in the outskirts of the city and over 35,000 deported. This came to be known as the Odessa Massacre. Most of the atrocities were committed during the first 6 months of the occupation, which officially began on the 17th of October 1941. When 80% of the 210,000 Jews in the region were killed, compared to Jews in Romania proper where the majority survived. After the Nazi forces began to lose ground on the Eastern Front, the Romanian administration changed its policy, refusing to deport the remaining Jewish population to extermination camps in German-occupied Poland, and allowing Jews to work as hired laborers. As a result, despite the events of 1941, the survival of the Jewish population in this area was higher than in other areas of occupied Eastern Europe. The city suffered severe damage and sustained many casualties over the course of the war. Many parts of Odessa were damaged during both its siege and recapture on the 10th of April 1944, when the city was finally liberated by the Red Army. Some of the Odessans had a more favorable view of the Romanian occupation, in contrast with the Soviet official view that the period was exclusively a time of hardship, deprivation, oppression and suffering, claims embodied in public monuments and disseminated through the media to this day. Subsequent Soviet policies imprisoned and executed numerous Odessans on account of collaboration with the occupiers. Post-war history. During the 1960s and 1970s, the city grew. Nevertheless, the majority of Odessa's Jews emigrated to Israel, the United States and other Western countries between the 1970s and 1990s. Many ended up in the Brooklyn neighborhood of Brighton Beach, sometimes known as Little Odessa. Domestic migration of the Odessan middle and upper classes to Moscow and Leningrad, cities that offered even greater opportunities for career advancement, also occurred on a large scale. Despite this, the city grew rapidly by filling the void of those left with new migrants from rural Ukraine and industrial professionals invited from all over the Soviet Union. As a part of the Ukrainian Soviet Socialist Republic, the city preserved and somewhat reinforced its unique cosmopolitan mix of Russian, Ukrainian, Jewish culture and a predominantly Russophone environment with the uniquely accented dialect of Russian spoken in the city. The city's unique identity has been formed largely thanks to its varied demography. All the city's communities have influenced aspects of Odessan life in some way or form. Odessa is a city of more than 1 million people. The city's industries include shipbuilding, oil refining, chemicals, metalworking, and food processing. Odessa is also a Ukrainian naval base and home to a fishing fleet. It is known for its large outdoor market, the 7th Kilometer Market, the largest of its kind in Europe. The city has seen violence in the 2014 pro-Russian conflict in Ukraine during 2014 Odessa clashes. The 2nd of May 2014, Odessa clashes between pro-Ukrainian and pro-Russian protesters killed 42 people. Four were killed during the protests, and at least 32 trade unionists were killed after a trade union building was set on fire after Molotov cocktails exchanged between sides. Polls conducted from September to December 2014 found no support for joining Russia. Odessa was struck by three bomb blasts in December 2014, one of which killed one person. Internal Affairs Ministry advisor Zorian Shkryak said on the 25th of December that Odessa and Kharkiv had become cities which are being used to escalate tensions in Ukraine. Shkryak said that he suspected that these cities were singled out because of their geographic position. On the 5th of January 2015, the city's Euromaidan Coordination Center and a cargo train car were bombed. Geography. Location. Odessa is situated on terraced hills overlooking a small harbor on the Black Sea in the Gulf of Odessa, approximately 31 kilometers north of the estuary of the Dniester River and some 443 kilometers south of the Ukrainian capital Kiev. The average elevation at which the city is located is around 50 meters, while the maximum is 65 meters and minimum amounts to 4.2 meters above sea level. The city currently covers a territory of 162.42 kilometers, the population density for which is around 6,139 persons per square kilometer. Sources of running water in the city include the Dniester River, from which water is taken and then purified at a processing plant just outside the city. Being located in the south of Ukraine, the topography of the area surrounding the city is typically flat and there are no large mountains or hills for many kilometers around. Flora is of the deciduous variety and Odessa is known for its tree-lined avenues which, in the late 19th and early 20th centuries, made the city a favorite year-round retreat for the Russian aristocracy. The city's location on the coast of the Black Sea has also helped to create a booming tourist industry in Odessa. The city's Arcadia Beach has long been a favorite place for relaxation, both for the city's inhabitants and its visitors. This is a large sandy beach which is located to the south of the city center. Odessa's many sandy beaches are considered to be quite unique in Ukraine, as the country's southern coast tends to be a location in which the formation of stony and pebble beaches has proliferated. The coastal cliffs adjacent to the city are home to frequent landslides, resulting in a typical change of landscape along the Black Sea. Due to the fluctuating slopes of land, city planners are responsible for monitoring the stability of such areas, and for preserving potentially threatened building and other structures of the city above sea level near water. Also, a potential danger to the infrastructure and architecture of the city is the presence of multiple openings underground. These cavities can cause buildings to collapse, resulting in a loss of money and business. Due to the effects of climate and weather on sedimentary rocks beneath the city, the result is instability under some buildings' foundations. Climate. Odessa has a hot summer humid continental climate that borderlines the semi-arid climate as well as a humid subtropical climate. This has, over the past few centuries, aided the city greatly in creating conditions necessary for the development of summer tourism. During the Tsarist era, Odessa's climate was considered to be beneficial for the body, and thus many wealthy but sickly persons were sent to the city in order to relax and recuperate. This resulted in the development of spa culture and the establishment of a number of high-end hotels in the city. The average annual temperature of sea is 13 to 14 degrees Celsius, whilst seasonal temperatures range from an average of 6 degrees Celsius in the period from January to March, to 23 degrees Celsius in August. Typically, for a total of 4 months, from June to September, the average sea temperature in the Gulf of Odessa and city's Bay Area exceeds 20 degrees Celsius. The city typically experiences dry, cold winters, which are relatively mild when compared to most of Ukraine as they're marked by temperatures which rarely fall below minus 10 degrees Celsius. Summers, on the other hand, do see an increased level of precipitation, and the city often experiences warm weather with temperatures often reaching into the high 20s and low 30s. Snow cover is often light or moderate, and municipal services rarely experience the same problems that can often be found in other, more northern, Ukrainian cities. This is largely because the higher winter temperatures and coastal location of Odessa prevent significant snowfall. Additionally, the city hardly ever faces the phenomenon of sea freezing. Thank you.
We'll be right back. We'll be right back. We'll be right back.